Hello, people. I am Jabby Kuwe, joined by Natasha Martinez.
Hello.
And we're looking at when a maid... the caffeine is like shrinking things. I already am a little bit dyslexic and the caffeine's making it slightly worse. Okay. I got a funny feeling. We're looking at when a mermaid hits puberty from Carminati. Yeah. So I have no idea what we're in for here, but you can count on Carminati to keep it interesting. Thank you, Carminati, for allowing us to react to this. Very, very much appreciate it. And here we go.
Why is it?
एक मिनट ये मुझे क्यों टैग कर रखा है
एक द रेट केरी बिनाती
इश क्या कर रहे हो यार तुम लोग कोई तीसरा बंदा देखेगा उसे लगेगा ये पोज मुझे डेडिकेटेड है यार क्या कर रहे हो मत करो ऐसे काम जेल नहीं जाना है मुझे खैर इस बच्चों के सपने तोड़ने वाली जलपरी का नाम है जुनैद मखदूम जुनैद और ये है
पोर्न स्टार ऑफ पाकिस्तान पोर्न स्टार ऑफ पाकिस्तान
यार ये उस साइड कुछ गलत चल रहा है क्या पहले वो गाजर खाने वाला दानव फिर वो लजंड और अब ये
आज ना मैं आप लोगों से ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि जिस चीज को मेरे साथ डेट पे जाना है या जिस चीज को मेरे साथ सेक्स मीटिंग करनी है
सेक्स मीटिंग तो छोड़ो इसके साथ नॉर्मल मीटिंग करना भी अपराध माना जाता है नहीं सोचो ये जलपरी मीटिंग पे जा रही है
जी आ गए सब लोग फल फूल पड़े हैं साइड में खाने किसी को तो पिछली बार जैसा मैं
Oh Lord! Oh yucky, ducky! That's just too yucky.
Yuck!
What are
you doing?
Let's stop.
Ew! Come on,
Oh my God!
This was not the mermaid video I was expecting.
इसमें कौन सा शक है मैं चूसता इतने प्यार से हूँ
ये अकेली ऐसी बच्ची है जो डायरेक्ट घोड़े का दूध पीती है और घोड़े को पता तक नहीं चलता तुम लोग पूछोगे कैसे ये चूसता इतने प्यार से
मैं चूसता इतने प्यार से हूँ
सुबह से फिर शाम तक मुझे प्यार करो ओ प्यार करो
हाँ ये जो इंडिया पाकिस्तान के बीच में हल्दी घाटी दिखा रहा है ना किसी की इच्छा नहीं है देखने की ये जो दो पहाड़ों के बीच में गड्ढा है कौन भरेगा उसे
मेरी तरह तुम भी कभी
मुंह में लेके
देखो
अब इसका मस्त कराची पे इंटरव्यू आया था आओ ताड़े
और ये हम लाइव आ चुके हैं मस्त कराची के पेज पे हमारे साथ जुड़े हैं अपना इंट्रोडक्शन दीजिए
मखदूम जुनैद द पॉर्न स्टार ऑफ पाकिस्तान
सर जनाब ये बताइए इतने दिन कहाँ मसरूफ थे आप
इतने दिन में सेक्स मीटिंग्स में मसरूफ था
क्या बात है
ओह माय गॉश
अरे आराम से शांत हो जाइए ये बताइए ये एक सेक्स मीटिंग का कितना चार्ज करते हैं आप
आई विल चार्ज वेरी वेरी बिग अमाउंट For one sex meeting, so shut up.
जनाब गुस्सा काहे हो रहे हैं? पहले ये बताइए, आपका कोई परिवार का सदस्य आया है? या फिर कोई भाई बहन जो घर से लाइव आ जाए?
तुम्हारी बहन लाइव नहीं आती क्या?
जनाब आपकी चर्चा हो रही है, आपकी बहन आएगी हमारी बहन ऐसी बातें कर रहा है?
नहीं वो चिप चिप के आती होगी ना तुम्हारे सामने नहीं आती होगी वो अपने रूम में कपड़े उतार के आती होगी और स्ट्रिप डांस करती होगी
जनाब अपनी जबान पे लगाम दे आपकी बात हो रही है आपकी बहन लाइव आएगी हमारी बहन और इन्हें किसने बताया हमारी बहन क्या करती है आप और मैं मिलकर बात करेंगे इसके बाद खैर आप ये बताइए ये जो पुलिस फोर्स है हमारी हमारी सुरक्षा करती है, तो उनके बारे में दो लाइनें।
सारे थानेदार हैं मेरे ताबेदार, सारे थानेदार हैं मेरे ताबेदार।
कहाँ से पकड़ के लाओ भाई? ये बताइए, what do you do for your living?
What do you for living? I don't know क्या?
आपको ये नहीं पता आप क्या करते हैं? बावली गांड क्या बे? चुम्मी क्यों दे दी भाई?
Don't call me भाई, I'm not a भाई, I'm only Johnny sexy hot baby.
हम आपको मार, अरे गांड कहाँ दिखा रहे हो भाई? आप थोड़े हम ही जा रहे हैं भाई, चल सही है भाई, तुम्हारी जिंदगी हराम कर दी हमारी मलका से।
अब ये चल पड़ी होती है तो उसके दोस्त कैसे होंगे?
नासिर, नोमान, हम सब फ्रेंड्स हैं।
मुझे लग ही रहा था ये और इसके सारे दोस्त मिलके हमको
पागल बना रहे मादर चोद के बच्चे।
और अभी तो रुको, क्लाइमेक्स अभी बाकी है।
हेलो,
ये जरूरत से ज्यादा सफेद नहीं लग रहा?
बहुत ज्यादा सेक्सी एंड हॉट फील कर रहा हूँ। आप इस वक्त मेरी कंडीशन भी देख सकते हैं, मेरे क्लॉथ्स की, कितना ज्यादा सेक्सी फील कर रहा हूँ।
हाँ, दिख रही है तेरे क्लॉथ्स की कंडीशन। ऐसा शर्ट खोल के लोग फुटपाथ पे सोते हैं और कभी कभी कुत्ता छाती पे मूंद के चला जाता है, फिर सेक्सी का तो पता नहीं, हॉट जरूर फील करते हैं। नहीं, वापस ले अपनी चुम्मी। इस चुम्मी से हुई 3,500 और 250 घायल। प्यूबर्टी ने इतने तेज धक्का मारा है ना, और फिर इसे सेक्स मीटिंग करनी है। कौन करेगा इसके साथ सेक्स मीटिंग? अगर आज तक इसने किसी के साथ सेक्स मीटिंग की होगी ना, मैं अपनी मूछें कटवा लूंगा।
Oh Lord.
Oh no.
So you found a papa bear. Is that what happened?
I think so, yeah. And posted pictures of it.
That's his Yoda. Yoda doll. He's got a shaved mustache.
ऐसे काम करता ही क्यों? तो यार बस आज के लिए सिर्फ इतना ही। अब इसी चीज का इंतजार रहेगा कि ये बिग बॉस में कब आता है। अब अगर तुम लोगों को ये वीडियो पसंद आई तो यार लाइक मारो। एम करते हैं 260,000 लाइक्स के लिए।
He always asks for a certain number of likes and then obliterates that number.
सब्सक्राइब करो, वो जो लाल वाला बटन है उसके साथ सेक्स मीटिंग करो या फिर बेफालतू की उसे चुम्मियां दो, मुझे नहीं पता, बस क्लिक हो जाना चाहिए। अब मैं भी जा रहा हूँ यार, ठीक करेंगे इसको। बाय मोहित। अरे पूछो वो सेक्स मीटिंग के लिए फ्री है?
मेरी अपनी ATM मशीन।
I don't know what that was. But okay, so before we dissect this, there's something I need to call out and I need to mention. So some people have gotten annoyed with Carrie Minotti because they are calling him homophobic. I watch this and it's like, it's hard to argue against that notion that he is or isn't. And so I'm sure he's got a lot of defenders who would say otherwise, who would be like, no, he's just making jokes, which this obviously is. It's all just a joke at this dude's expense. I don't have any reason to necessarily believe that he's homophobic. I have gay friends in my life. I get uncomfortable watching this video.
So do I.
Yeah, exactly. And, but like, it's just like, it's so out there. You had me watch the WAP video with you,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And so like, I get uncomfortable when anything is too overt, whether it's a man or a woman. Obviously less so with a woman. Either one, it's gonna make me uncomfortable. I forget what it was. Oh, that's what it was. We were watching Made in Heaven and I was kind of talking about that. Made in Heaven is an Indian show by Amazon. There's a lot of very aggressive homosexual stuff in there, right?
Okay.
And so like, I get uncomfortable already when there's like heterosexual aggressive stuff. And so when it's like that, it's like, it's even worse. Like, I can't even put myself in the situation, as Bill Burr would say. Like, it's just like, now it's like, I can't look at all. Made in Heaven, that's a great reference still, because there was a scene when it was a heterosexual moment between a girl and a boy where they were just kissing. Mm-hmm. And it was just going on for a long time. And I'm like, yo, I think I got the point.
You're like okay.
I get it. I'm saying all this as a sort of disclaimer against the notion of this conversation being remotely homophobic, because it's not about that. Innately, something about it makes me uncomfortable. And it has nothing to do with the dude being gay or whatever. It's just like, I just don't like that sort of display of whatever the hell that is.
Well, like, it's more so like, yeah, obviously, like, we're not homophobic. And right. It's more so like how he's doing it also, and just the way that he's soliciting himself. Mm-hmm. It's just like, it's creepy.
Yes.
Anyways, it would be creepy if it was a girl
yeah.
that was this, you know, I guess same, just everything that he does.
Same quality.
Honestly, I was like, oh, cool. Like, maybe this is an imagining of what a mermaid would be like in puberty. Like, I was, I don't know.
I was like, Carrie Minotti before.
I think the one time before with the TikTok video, which I wasn't that mad, okay? Like, people were like, you were so angry. I was just defending my TikTok, all right? I haven't seen
That's
much.
That's hilarious because I actually cut it down hard. I actually cut
because
down a lot of
too like passionate.
You were getting so aggro in that video, and I actually cut it down. I was like, we don't need that much aggro in this. And people still accuse you of that. That's kind of amazing because I cut it in such a way where I'm like, I'm trying to make sure that your points are coming across.
Well, it was more so like, we think you're angry, but it's not the way that you thought. Like, okay, don't okay, be okay. upset. Like, they weren't like mad at me for okay. that. And I wasn't mad. I was just, yeah. you know.
Well, no, I mean,
but I'm still getting to learn about him, I
right.
guess, is my point of bringing up that video.
In that particular one though, like, I knew what you wanted to communicate, and so I tried to make sure I edited in such a way to get those points across without it being mired in emotion.
Yeah.
Because I think that sometimes when people put that out there, they sort of lose sight of the thing you're trying to say. I stripped it of that in an effort to make the message more clean, if that makes
Thank
any sense.
Thank you for editing me. Yeah, you get passionate about something,
yeah.
it gets lost in translation. But I literally was thinking, like, this was gonna be some imagining skit about a mermaid,
yeah.
and then I just see the pose.
Yeah.
And I immediately thought of influencers in the wild. Have you followed that Instagram account?
No, but there's a Ryan George video you need to see.
Okay.
Where he catches, what do you call it, an abandoned TikToker in the wild.
I mean, yeah. this, you guys have to like check it out if you haven't already, but it's just basically calling out all of these ridiculous people who, especially when they're doing like beach shoots and they're just like on the sand, mm-hmm. like whatever and whatever. I've done that too. But like when you see it out of context, you're just like, oh my God, this is so cringe. And so from that moment that I saw him laying on the beach, I was like, cringe. And then it was like, cringe.
Yeah.
Like, I gotta look away.
There's some YouTube video you can find related to that idea. I forget what it was called, but it's something about how these people were posing thinking that it was a photo that they were taking, but it was just video. And you see how people behave when they're getting ready to take a photo that is very unnatural and not human. And they go,
not human.
And they hold that pose as if like, oh, it's like, why? When do you actually do that in real life? Never. So why are you doing it in a photo? It's stupid, just stop.
Oh my
and
God.
So I try to make a habit of taking photos with a longer lens so people don't know I'm taking photos. So I'm catching them looking good while they're just being natural.
Yeah.
That is the most interesting kind of photo, not you going, and posing. I mean, sometimes I do it too, but like, I try not to as much, you know? But regarding this, like, one of the things that's made me, this reminded me is, because I've gotten accused of being homophobic too at certain points, because I'm very much like, I'm very anti super effeminate anything.
Mm.
That's my thing, because even if it's a girl who's acting super like too much of that, I'm like, you're just a headache. Like, I'm gonna go this way. I don't wanna deal with you.
Yeah.
You know, so if it's a guy or a girl acting like level 1000 effeminate, like to the point that you're a caricature of a human,
mm-hmm.
I'm like, it's cringy to me and I'm walking this way.
First of all, I think that's what this person was, a caricature, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it's like, how did Carrie Minotti find him? Was it
so
just
he sent to him, probably.
It was just like he tagged him in a thing and then he's just like, he took a deep dive into his archives of
we got
videos
tagged.
And stuff? Oh, okay.
I mean, said it, he got tagged in the thing. It's like, why did he, I don't know, I wouldn't imagine that.
But then all the videos, I'm like, he just like found them on his like site or something? I don't know. When he had this shirt open, I was like, oh no, please like don't go lower. Like, mm-hmm. it's just too much, it's too much.
How do you feel about when you see girls or guys that are like extremely, extremely effeminate to the point of caricature? Because I find that it bothers me more than the average person. It's just like, man up. Like, I don't mean that in like the toxic masculinity way. It's just like, how do you expect to survive? Like, I don't know, some part of innate like primal thing
yeah.
that kicks in where I'm like, I don't understand that function. Like, what that, like, you just, do you wake up like this? Like, is this really who you are day in and day out?
I know what you're talking about. Yeah. I haven't had many like personal experiences like being around people that like, it's really is like they are just a character. But that being said, like, I don't vibe with those people
okay.
because they're not being real. It doesn't have to do with, I think, the feminine aspect of it.
That's the only word I could think of. Like, what would you call that? So it's not that word.
It's the attention. It's the attention seeking.
There you
me.
Go.
Attention
you go.
Seeking.
No, you're right.
That's what it is.
That's the phrase I'm in desperate yes. need of is the attention seekers.
That's what it is.
It's irritating as hell. Mm-hmm. You come across this in both sexes.
It is both sexes. I mean, I did pageants for many, many years, mm-hmm. and I competed with a lot of these people. And yeah. it's just like, you don't have to be like that extra.
Yeah.
But for some reason, some people do, just because I think it's going to work in their favor. That's a great word, actually.
Extra. It's just the extra, yeah. extra personality. And they're so full of themselves, they're attention seekers, and it's like, you know, go home.
Yeah, like how are they when they're in their places, like alone by themselves? Are they that way still?
But anyway, back to this.
Back to this cringy video.
The way he took it apart, you know, my favorite part of this was actually when he was acting opposite of the dude, pretending yeah. like he was having a conversation with him. I thought that was really good.
Yeah, that was funny.
It was well done.
And then when he shaved his mustache at the end, like he's like, who's actually having these meetings? I'm gonna shave my mustache if he has one, and then boop, it's gone.
I thought it was well put together.
Yeah, I liked it. It was funny. It was cringy, but funny.
I think that's what it comes down to, like in short, is I just don't like cringy personalities. That's mm-hmm. what it comes down to. And maybe I'm one, but like,
yeah,
it's
I
just
cringe
like,
all the time.
Yeah.
I'm just like,
it's just a lot. It's just like, why you just too much work. It's if you're a headache just to talk to, I don't want to deal with you. I think that's what it comes down to. And this person is super extra, super attention seeking, super headache inducing.
Mm-hmm.
And like, yeah. So anyway, cool. That was fun. You guys, thanks so much for hanging out. And I'm Javi Coy. This is
Natasha Martinez.
Peace out.